ABC 7 Bangor.
This is ABC 7 News at Noon.
Hey, Susan, happy Thursday afternoon. Your first weather forecast brought to you by Lurgy and Fredericks across from Eastern Maine Medical Center, serving the greater Bangor area for over 65 years. Radar and satellite, all right, we had some rain moving through recently. Now things are starting to calm down, moving from the west to the east. So we're finally done with all the excitement, though. We're going to be watching to see if we get a few isolated showers going during the afternoon period. There's a small chance that could try to develop. But really, once this tracks off towards the east, we're seeing that now. We're going to be watching for our next round of showers and storms that will be tracking off towards the east later on. And that will hit us as we head towards the weekend. So here's what we're looking at here. A nice late chance for a shower that could develop. Otherwise, though, a lot of sunshine. But more clouds on the way later on tonight with a chance for a few thunderstorms again as we move forward soon with an isolated chance tomorrow. But 5 to 10 mile per hour winds being noted, though, that will be seen throughout the next day or so. But more gusty winds will try to move in as we head towards your Friday. So your forecast for today, 80 degrees, partly cloudy with a few showers possible. We're starting to see those tapering off now. Mainly more of an isolated chance with that northwest wind getting up to about 5 to 10 miles per hour. Later on tonight, middle 50s under a mostly cloudy sky, and the wind overall looking nice and calm. For tomorrow, upper 80s getting hot out there, mostly cloudy with an isolated thunderstorm or two possible. South wind getting up to about 20 miles per hour. And your hourly forecast for the rest of the afternoon period, not too bad overall. Washington temperatures making into the 80s with a mixture of clouds and sun. Your full 5-day forecast is coming up. Susan?
Thank you, Devin. Firefighters responded to a house blaze in Orrington around 6:15 last night. Good afternoon. I'm Susan Farley. Thank you for joining us this afternoon. Also, Governor Mills has announced a $15 million grant to fund Maine's coastal seafood dealers. We'll look at where the money will go. And a new property tax law is set to take effect in August. We'll explain what that means to Maine seniors. That's coming up along with the rest of our stories. And first this noon, firefighters responded to a house fire in Orrington around 6:15 last night after a dryer caught on fire. Homeowner Edward Miller says firefighters arrived quickly after he and his son called 911. Miller says he always cleans out the lint from his dryer, but knows things can like this can potentially happen.
My son and I were outside talking, and then we heard the fire alarm, so he went in there and says, oh, we got smokes, and we turned on the hose, and he says it was a dryer fire, and then he called 911, and he defended in place and put most of it out before the fire got here because we didn't want it to spread.
Miller says he and his home are safe and thanks the Orrington, Brewer, and Holden fire departments for helping put out the fire. The Penobscot County Sheriff's Office is investigating a fatal crash involving a motorcycle and a passenger vehicle in Glenburn. The Sheriff's Office says the crash happened in front of the Village Variety Store on Route 15. The initial investigation revealed the motorcycle was traveling north on Route 15 when a passenger car traveling south turned into the store in front of the motorcycle. The operator of the motorcycle, 61-year-old Andrew Adams of Glenburn, was transported to Northern Light Eastern Maine Medical Center in Bangor, where he was later pronounced dead. The passenger vehicle driven by 40-year-old Jonathan Hendry of Hudson. There were two passengers, 40-year-old Sarah Saltzman and her 6-year-old daughter. None of them were injured. The crash remains under investigation. Anyone with information is asked to call the Penobscot County Sheriff's Office Criminal Investigation Division at 947-4585. A 1-year-old boy is in critical condition after being found unresponsive. According to Maine State Police spokesperson Shannon Moss, the Clinton Police Department responded to a home on Elwood Drive in Clinton for a report of a drowning around 7 p.m. Tuesday night. Moss said a 1-year-old child who lived at the home was found outside by his mother in a plastic tote that had water in it. Moss says the mother discovered her son after being alerted by another child. A Clinton police officer and rescue crews arrived and performed life-saving measures. The child was transported to a local hospital and later flown to Maine Medical Center by Life Flight, where he is in critical condition. Maine State Police detectives are investigating the circumstances of that incident. A Palmyra man was sentenced in federal court Wednesday on a child pornography charge. According to the Department of Justice, 44-year-old Jason Colcord was sentenced to a little over 12 years in prison and 5 years of supervised release. He was also ordered to pay $8,000 in restitution. Colcord pleaded guilty in November of 2021 to one count of access with intent to view child pornography. According to the DOJ, court records show between December 2019 and February 2020, Colcord knowingly accessed a phone that contained images of child pornography with the intent to view. Many of the images involved minors under the age of 12. Records indicate he downloaded multiple images using an online peer-to-peer file-sharing network and viewed the images on his phone. The Penobscot County Grand Jury has indicted two people in connection with their infant being found in cardiac arrest. Emergency medical services responded to the home of 22-year-old Taji DePetri and 26-year-old Zachary Borg and Corinna in June of 2021. Court records indicate they found their 11-month-old in cardiac arrest. Records said fentanyl was found in the several rooms and the baby's crib. They were indicted on several charges, including aggravated assault, domestic violence, reckless conduct with a dangerous weapon, and endangering the welfare of a child. An Orneville man was indicted for allegedly kidnapping his 4-year-old son in April. Dexter police said they received a complaint that 32-year-old Travis Lala allegedly took the child from his mother's arms and took off in a vehicle. Police said Lala allegedly came back and tried to take his 2-year-old daughter as well, but was unable to and fled into the woods behind the home. He was eventually taken into custody. The child was not injured. He was indicted on a multitude of charges, including kidnapping, domestic violence, criminal threatening, and assault. Coming up on ABC 7 News at noon, a public meeting was held at Bangor City Hall last night to get input on its new bus system before it rolls out. We'll take a look when we return.
The greatest hits from the best of times are right back where they started. Z62 is playing the hits again. Z62 Retro Radio. We played them first and we're playing them again.
Z62.
Did you know that motorcyclists are 27 times more likely to die in a motor vehicle crash than passenger vehicle occupants? Motorcycles can be hard to see. We need to look twice to save a life. Let's watch for motorcycles and share the road. Please remember to leave extra room when following motorcycles, and to check in your rearview mirrors and blind spots, and to be extra careful when making left-hand turns. Remember, your actions can save lives. The Maine Bureau of Highway Safety reminds you to look twice to save a life.
Nearly all commercial vehicles carry big insurance policies. So if you're hurt by one of these box trucks, or by a garbage truck, or by any kind of commercial vehicle, you may have a big case worth big money. But they don't just give that money up. You need someone who's going to fight for it. That's exactly why you need to call the Twos. I'm Jim with Lowry & Associates. If you've been hurt by any commercial truck, call the Twos. We win for you.
Hurt by a commercial truck? Call the Twos. Call 222-2222.
On the Road, broadcasting the news at 6, live from Bucksport, is sponsored by Bob's Small Engines, your dealer for CF Moto side-by-sides, Husqvarna chainsaws, BCS tillers, and Echo Power products. Supported by Jenkins Beach in Dedham, a family beach in a protected area featuring swimming and rentals for watercraft and cottages. And supported by John R. Crooker Insurance Agency in Bucksport for personal and commercial insurance.
The fender bender.
She was cutting right in front of me.
I was already in the left-hand lane when she came up behind me.
The innocent onlooker.
You got involved because you witnessed the accident.
I was right there, yes.
You want to tell me who's telling me the truth?
But will she get damaged in the process?
The defendant is the blue vehicle. I was behind her.
She's lying.
Somebody who drives around without insurance doesn't speak.
Next, Judge Judy.
Thursday at 5, only on ABC 7.
Everything hurts. Everything's expensive. Let's not even talk about your hair. Enough! Here at Z62, we hit the rewind button. Z62 is playing the hits again. Z62 is back with the greatest hits from the best of times.
You're watching ABC 7 Bangor.
Governor Mills announced $15 million in grant funding for coastal seafood dealers Wednesday. A.J. Douglas was there.
These funds are going to help us push through
to make a real game-changing innovation in technology.
Wednesday, Governor Mills announced more than $15 million in funding would go to seafood dealers and processors throughout the coast of Maine. The funds will be used to support seafood dealers as they recover from the economic impacts linked to the COVID-19 pandemic.
A lot of these businesses had to invest money in workplace adaptation or adapting to changes in the market as a result of the pandemic. So they had to defer important investments in their businesses and infrastructure and equipment and things like that that will help them move forward.
The Mills administration made funding available through the Seafood Dealer and Processor COVID-19 Response and Resilience Program, which was created through the governor's Maine Jobs and Recovery Plan. $10 million will come from the governor's job plan, and the additional $5 million will come from the Federal Consolidated Appropriations Act.
It means stability for Maine businesses, means stability for Maine families, it means stability for Maine's communities. Thousands and thousands of people depend on the seafood industry, and we can't skip a step in supporting every line in the chain of that process.
Hugh Reynolds has been in the lobster fishing industry for the past 25 years. He explains one of the many adjustments he has had to make due to a lack of labor options.
Our lobster processing starts with a high pressure machine where we put all of our lobsters under pressure, which reduces labor for extraction and increases the quality of the products that come out of the machine.
Shellfish company owner Alex DeConing announced their mussels will be available at 150 Hannaford stores because he purchased a bagging machine thanks to the available grant funding. In Trenton, A.J. Douglas, ABC 7, Fox 22.
A public meeting was held at Bangor City Hall last night to get input on its new bus transit system before it rolls out later this fall. Our Stephanie Wittenbach has more.
Superintendent of Community Connector of Bangor, Lori Linscott, says that Pickering Square right behind me under construction will now be done this fall, including a new schedule for the city with fixed stops. And with anything new, there are some new concerns. Let's take a look.
The Community Connector Service is asking the city for public comments before it implements its new bus schedule and fixed stop system. City of Brewer Mayor Michelle Daniels attended Wednesday's public meeting and hopes Community Connector leaders will take one of her concerns into consideration.
One of my main concerns are handicapped individuals that are going to have to walk more than to the end of their street to pick up a bus.
Daniel says there are other services available, such as non-emergency transportation through the state, but not everybody qualifies.
Some of the things that they're proposing are very good. Some of the things need to have more time.
Transportation planner Maddie Jensen for the Bangor Area Comprehensive Transportation System says because the changes are drastic for riders, they will be implemented slowly.
It's going to be implemented slowly over the next 6 to 12 months to get riders used to things, show them where they should be going.
Bus Superintendent Lori Linscott says the company is taking comments until July 20th. One resident who does not want to be named says his biggest concern is making sure one of the stops is not in front of his business.
We want to hear from the public. We want them to let us know if we've done a good job at choosing where the bus stops will be on each route.
In Bangor, I'm Stephanie Wittenbach reporting for ABC 7 and Fox 22.
A new property law that will impact Maine senior citizens is set to take effect in August. Matthew Jaronczyk has the story.
Starting August 8th, Maine residents who are 65 and older will have the opportunity to freeze their future property tax rates at the current level. Known as the Property Tax Stability Program, the Act intends to stabilize property taxes for senior citizens who have owned a home for at least 10 years. The bill was sponsored by Aroostook Senator Trey Stewart, who says he felt like seniors in the state living off fixed incomes should not have to worry about whether they can afford their taxes.
Most of the time they're on fixed incomes. And those incomes don't keep up with the rising cost of everything. Social Security might go up a few bucks a year, but as we're seeing right now with inflation and other increasing costs, including in some cases property taxes. And that can be a really big burden.
Besides the age requirement in owning a property for at least a decade, seniors must also meet other requirements for the exemption. Once approved, eligible homeowners who sell their property can transfer the set tax level to another property anywhere in the state. For senior citizens like Richard Smith, the bill would allow him to stay in his home.
If the property taxes keep going up, I may not be able to afford to live here. May have to move into a old folks' home, an apartment building somewhere.
Comments like these are why Stewart made this bill a top priority.
What the law says now is that going forward, your rate will be fixed at whatever year you go in, as early as this year. And in theory, if you apply before the end of this year with your local community, you can freeze what your actual dollar amount is that you owe to that locality, and to really target it towards senior citizens in Maine, and particularly those folks that might be struggling.
Matthew Jaroncic, ABC 7, Fox 22.
With Thursday's business news, here's Leo Jonasson.
The Fed now believes it can slow down inflation. That's the word from Federal Reserve Chair Jerome Powell speaking at a banking forum in Portugal. Powell asserts that the Fed can control inflation by raising interest rates. Spirit Airlines is delaying a shareholder vote on a proposed merger with Frontier. The deal was supposed to happen today, but it's been pushed back till July 8th to allow more talks with Frontier and JetBlue, which has put in its own bid for Spirit. Bed Bath & Beyond CEO Mark Tritton is out after less than 3 years, this after sales plunged 25% in the most recent quarter. And there's a movement to kick TikTok out of app stores. FCC Commissioner Brendan Carr is urging both Apple and Google to boot the short video app because it collects sensitive user data that's then accessed by the Chinese government. I'm Leo Jonasson with Thursday's Business on ABC 7.
Coming up, the Department of Justice's Criminal Division unveiled a new initiative for illegal opioid prescriptions Wednesday. When we return, we'll take a look at the details. We'll be right back.
It was nearly 50 years ago this average Joe from Portland opened his doors. He set out to help his fellow Mainers through tough times. Through compassion, clarity, and courage, he's helped over 25,000 injured and disabled Mainers get the justice they deserve. The Law Offices of Joe Bornstein, proudly celebrating nearly 50 years of practicing law in all 16 counties. We're Maine lawyers working for Maine people and Maine people only since 1974. There's one number you need to know. It's called Joe.
Did you know you don't have to be 65 years old to qualify for Medicare and Medicaid? Many people who are already on Medicaid also qualify for a WellCare Medicare Advantage plan, which means you can start taking advantage of all these benefits right now. A $0 or low monthly plan premium, preventive and comprehensive dental coverage, hearing coverage, vision coverage, and prescription drug coverage with free home delivery, plus extra benefits like free over-the-counter healthcare items, free transportation, free gym membership, home-delivered meals, and WellCare's telehealth services, which include online doctor visits and a 24-hour nurse advice line. If you know you're eligible or think you might be, call 1-844-918-0047. We'll send you our free Medicare all-in-one guide or visit enrollwellcare.com to enroll now. WellCare. It's Medicare done well.
Who says you can't get 100% whiter teeth? Try Crest Whitening Emulsions. Remove 10 years of stains in just 4 days. And it's enamel safe for everyday use. Better, faster, 100% whiter teeth. Crest, the number one teeth whitening brand in America.
I like to boost it, my vitamins can boost it. I like to boost it, we like to boost it.
Boost. A fizzing, amazing vitamin boost.
ABC 7, Fox 22, CNK Variety, and Prouty Auto Body want to send you to see Keith Urban live in concert on his The Speed of Now World Tour with special guest Ingrid Andress, Saturday, July 23rd at the Maine Savings Amphitheater in Bangor. Sign up to win tickets by registering at CNK Variety in Herman and Prouty Auto Body in Dover Foxcroft. Win tickets to see Keith Urban July 23rd on the Bangor waterfront.
The Department of Justice's Criminal Division unveiled a new initiative focused on illegal opioid prescriptions Wednesday. Our Dylan Holloway has the story.
The New England Prescription Opioid Strike Force, otherwise known as NEPO, was established on Wednesday. The mission of the strike force is clear: to identify and investigate healthcare fraud schemes in the New England region and to prosecute individuals involved in the illegal distribution of prescription opioids and other prescribed controlled substances.
Maine's opioid overdose death rate has skyrocketed in recent years. The people of Maine are losing loved ones at an alarming rate. And Maine's entire law enforcement community has identified the opioid epidemic as the number one issue its officers are dealing with on a daily basis, with limited resources and staffing.
The strike force is described as a joint law enforcement effort that brings together resources and expertise from agencies such as the U.S. Department of Health and Human Services, Office of the Inspector General, the Criminal Division's Fraud Unit, the U.S. Drug Enforcement Agency, the U.S. Attorney's Offices for three federal districts, and the FBI. The NEPO strike force will focus on criminal conduct by physicians, pharmacists, and other medical professionals, specifically healthcare fraud and drug diversion offenses. Senator Susan Collins released a statement applauding the DOJ's formation of the strike force, saying in part, quote, "Last year, there were more than 9,500 drug overdoses in our state, and 636 Mainers died as a result, a tragic record. I have long advocated for an all-of-the-above approach to address the opioid epidemic that is harming countless families, and I appreciate this positive step taken by the Department of Justice. Curtailing the oversupply of opioids in communities will help reduce the number of gateways for addiction." The NEPO strike force will operate out of the Concord, New Hampshire area and support the three districts that make up the strike force, which are Maine, Vermont, and New Hampshire.
I would venture to guess that nobody in this room, not a single person, has not been affected personally or know somebody who's been affected personally by the opioid epidemic in this country. This issue is personal to me, as I know it is personal to many of you.
If you or someone you know is struggling with addiction, go to knowyouroptions.me. You can also contact 211 information to find local treatment programs. I'm Dylan Holloway reporting for ABC 7 and Fox 22.
Well, cardio exercise gets more attention for improving health. Pumping iron may have more benefits than just helping you look good in the mirror. With more, here's ABC's Justin Finch.
Flex, relax, flex, relax. Up, down, up, down. Each repetition helps grow those muscles and build strength. Now, new evidence shows lifting weights also adds years to your life. A new study from Tohoku University School of Medicine in Japan looked at studies from 2012 to 2020, most from the U.S. Researchers found strength training was associated with 10 to 17% lower risk of heart disease, cancer, and all-cause death. The most benefit was seen with 30 to 60 minutes of strength exercises per week. That means all you need is about two good workouts per week to see benefits. What's more, combining muscle with cardio exercises lowered risk of all-cause death by 40%. If you're new to strength exercises, here are some ideas to help you. Start with body weight exercises first, like arm circles, knee push-ups, lunges, or squats, before stacking on those weights. These are harder than they look, so you will feel the burn. Pick an exercise with or without weights that you can do 8 to 12 repetitions at a time before feeling tired. Doing faster exercises with less weight builds endurance, while slower, controlled movements build muscle. Lastly, have fun with it. Bring a friend, play a game, find a trainer. Do whatever you need to do to enjoy your time. With this Medical Minute, I'm Justin Finch.
When we return, Devin Biggs has your five-day forecast.
Their price, $30,000. Your price, $20. Can you tell the difference? Even expert jewelers have a difficult time distinguishing the diamond Z4CZ from mined diamonds because of their similarity. Now, for the first time ever, the fire and brilliance of flawless diamonds are captured in this beautiful ring, each perfectly complemented by a brilliant setting of sterling silver plate and offered at an unprecedented price. The Sterlington Collection proudly presents a true masterpiece. This exquisite ring features a flawless simulated diamond center stone of 2 3/4 carats surrounded by over 1 1/4 carats of round and tapered flawless baguettes. And now the stunning brilliance of diamond Z4 is affordable to virtually everyone. One jewelry industry professional who examined these rings marveled at their beauty and brilliance.
"It's exceedingly rare to see such flawless stones."
He's right. Comparable solitaires made of diamonds can cost up to $30,000.
"I was shocked that the stones in these rings weren't diamonds."
Even perfect natural diamonds have flaws, but every CZ stone in the Diamond Z4 is perfect in its color, clarity, and cut. And at a remarkable total weight of over 4 carats, it will become an instant favorite, turning heads and inspiring gasps of envy. You could pay over $30,000 for a diamond ring. But why, when you can have the Diamond Z4 for a fraction of the cost? Your price, through this special invitation, will be only $20. And for a limited time, order today, and you can also receive this beautiful band with 1.92 carats of Diamond Z4s. Every set comes with a certificate of authenticity, confirming the manufacturer's appraised value of $95. You get both CZ rings, totaling over an astounding 6 carats, for $20. Supplies are limited, so call or click now.
Call 1-800-401-3492 to get your special offer, Diamond Z4. Call now or go to DiamondZ4.com. So call 1-800-401-3492. That's 1-800-401-3492. This offer's not available in any store. Call now.
Governor's Restaurant and Bakery celebrated its 63rd birthday by hosting their annual Lobster Roll Day Wednesday. The restaurant chain sells lobster rolls at a discounted price for one day each year as part of the governor's June birthday celebration. Operations Director Jason Clay says the business is still dealing with a rise in food costs.
We have some great partners that we partner with every year for this, and we're able to kind of buy that ahead. And obviously it's more expensive. I mean, everything's more expensive these days, but we were able to get pretty much the same supplies we get every year.
The restaurant has hosted this event for the past 8 years and continues to navigate through unexpected barriers as the result of the COVID-19 pandemic. Now let's check your full forecast with Devin Biggs. Devin?
All righty, happy Thursday afternoon. Your full weather forecast brought to you by Scott's Recreation, New England's largest trailer dealer, home of Maine's lowest camper and tractor prices, with locations in Turner, Manchester, Herman, and Orono, Maine. All right, we had some rain moving through earlier this morning. That is since getting out of here. Most of us will stay dry for the rest of the afternoon period, but there is a small isolated chance for a shower to get going. But most of us should be under that dry spell throughout the daytime today, as high pressure is going to become our friend. We have this front moving through. We have high pressure right here. This warm front, though, is going to be moving in. That will equal some warmer temperatures that will be setting up. And, of course, some chances for showers and thunderstorms that will be arriving soon. But wave heights right now, 2 feet according to some of the buoys out there, so nothing totally outrageous. No advisories along the coast at this point, though. But some gusty winds may be up to 15 to 17 miles per hour today. Calming down later on tonight, though. But then tomorrow, more gusty winds on the way, getting up to about 20 to even 25 miles per hour in just a few areas. Our average high is now 79 degrees. We'll be in the lower 80s today, so right near average. Upper 80s, hot and humid by Friday. Lower 80s by Saturday, Sunday, and a Monday as well. The middle to upper 70s as we head towards Tuesday and a Wednesday. Alrighty, your muggy meter, though, showing dew points that'll be relatively decent, though, rising a little bit as we head towards Saturday, getting up into the middle 60s, falling back by Sunday into Monday, then rising again as we head towards next Tuesday. If you are heading out the door to see, your UV index forecast is at a 6. That is considered very high, or relatively high, I should say, with a burn time of around 30 minutes. So we're talking hats, sunglasses, sunscreen, shade. Still needed as you head out the door to avoid a bad sunburn. Moving forward, though, there's that small isolated chance for a shower. Most of us should stay dry today with a decent amount of sunshine and a few passing clouds. More clouds on the way later on tonight with isolated chances for a few thunderstorms again tomorrow. We'll hold on to the cloud chances, though, as we head towards the overnight period Friday night and Saturday with more thunderstorms on the way from time to time in just a few spots. So your forecast for the rest of today, the showers are backing off. Maybe a few isolated chances this afternoon. Otherwise, a partly cloudy sky, highs in the lower 80s, that northwest wind getting up to about 5 to 10 miles per hour. Later on time, middle 50s under a mostly cloudy sky, and the wind overall looking nice and calm. For tomorrow, upper 80s, mostly cloudy, a few isolated thunderstorms, hot and humid as well. South wind getting up to about 20 miles per hour. Alrighty, your Scott's Recreation extended forecast. More storms on the way by Saturday. Highs in the lower 80s. We're dry by Sunday. Partly cloudy. Highs in the lower 80s. Lower 80s again by Monday with a chance for storms.
Thank you, Devin. That's all for ABC 7 News at Noon. Thanks for watching. I'm Susan Farley. We'll see you this evening with Peter Dubois and Beth Jones on ABC 7 News at 6. Have a great afternoon and enjoy that sunshine.
Nobody should have to go through a five-hour drive every single day to have radiation. Sarah's House provides them a home away from home, a place where they can come and receive treatment and support while they move through their cancer journey. There are 9 bedrooms for guests on 2 floors. They have laundry facilities. Everyone has their own cupboard for dry storage, refrigerator space. The great room is really the heart of the home. It's like the kitchen living space. This is where people come together. They share meals, they share stories, and they support one another.
You're watching.